Hi, my name is Christian and I would like to present you the newest version of A157B, an alternative firmware for this wonderful module from Döpfer. You have to install the new software to have all these features, and if you're not sure what version you have installed, you can just go to the system menu, press Shift System, and then press this button here. And then you see here the version of the installed firmware. In this case, version 101. So what is new? Maybe you remember the performance modes. These are special modes where you can change the behavior of a track so that you use then this track to control other modules. For instance, you can change here track number 8 and change the gate mode to performance fader. In this case, these buttons here are like a small fader. So you can set here the position of this fader, and the output of the socket here is then defined by the position of this fader. So in this case, I have track number 6 is a normal trigger mode connected with a bass drum, and track number 8 is connected with the voltage control of the tune of the pitch parameter of this bass drum module. And so now I can change the tuning, the pitch of this bass drum. This maximum voltage here was until now 10 volt, and I changed it now so you can change this maximum voltage of this performance mode output, and you use the function gate length. It's not a length, it's a voltage, but it corresponds also to this track. And you see here now for track number 8 I have X stands for 10 as maximum voltage. You can change this to, let's say, 6, and now this position here of the fader is 6, but this position now is only 3 volt or 4.5. And well, let's use here another track with the tom-tom, and let's configure track number 7 as performance fader, also as performance fader. I can also use this performance keyboard, performance click, and so on. I have different performance gates, but I think performance fader is one of the most useful. And now I control with this fader here the pitch of the tom-tom. And again, I can change the maximum voltage of this control voltage. Of course, the exact voltage is defined by the position of this fader, but the maximum voltage here is defined by this parameter. And so you can adjust the maximum voltage to your module to arrange the voltage range the controlled module uses. Until now, the performance faders were the same for all patterns. So when you would change the pattern, pattern number 1 to pattern number 2, then these faders are the same. But I changed this behavior now, so now a different pattern has also different faders. So for instance, when I go here to this pattern and I program here the bass drum again, this fader here is dependent of the fader of this pattern. So you can define your own patterns, you can define for these patterns your faders, and then you can switch between the patterns. And I think, especially if you perform, it's a good feature. So you have different settings and you can change from one setting to another setting. If you like to go back to the previous behavior, it's no problem. There is a system parameter. The system parameter is called performance per pattern, PP. And if I go back to the old behavior and switch off this functionality, then you will see the fade is always the same. So when I change the patterns, this fade is here, stay the same. This was the behavior as it was before. This new version has also 10 new activities. Maybe you remember these activities. You can choose activities, and whenever you press this function 1, 2, 3, 4 button, one of these activities will then be activated. Or also, of course, when the socket has a voltage, and also with internal routing. So let's try this out for a simple example, and then I will show you the new activities. One simple example is if I choose the activity, generate step. So whenever I press this button 1, or the socket here has a voltage, or I have made the correct routing, a step will be generated, and I define with this function here what track will be considered. So in this case, this function 1 will work on track number 1. So whenever, let's start the sequencer. Whenever I press function 1, this track number 1 generates a step. You do not see the step here, it's in the background, but you hear the step. So now I can also use routing. So I go to the gate mode of track number 8 in this case, and I say, okay, whenever track number 8 has a step, this will be output but routed to function 1. I can here also choose function 2, 4, 5, also stop. So whenever track number 8 has a step, the sequence will stop or reset. It's also a routing. But let's go back and let's route this track number 8 to function 1. So when I have now here a step, you hear the step. Well, but this is funny, because this step here will not trigger the hi-hat. Hi-hat is output here by track number 1, socket number 1. This step here, or this 2 or 3 or 4 steps here, will route to function 1, to this button here. A step here is the same as I would press here this button. And then this function here is defined as generate step. You see here the step, yes, for track number 1. Okay, these are the basics of these activities and also the basics of the routing. So now let's use these basics now with this setup to use the new 10 different activities. Let's start with the activity called first and last. This activity last, let's stop the sequencer for a second and use the manual clock here. When I activate this activity last, when I press here this function 1 by hand here, then the playhead of this track number 1 jumps to the last step. So the activity jumps to the last step, and then with the next clock signal, it start the sequencer. With the next clock signal, then it goes, well, of course, to the next step. Defined by the sequence, defined by the pattern, defined by the direction, and so on. So whenever I press this function 1, this playhead jumps to the last step. I added another new feature, and I think this is now a good time to to show this, you can not only define one track as before as target of an activity or all tracks. This was possible in the last release, all or one single track. Now you can also define, well, it's exactly the tracks you would like. For this, you click here on these LEDs. So you can say not just track number one, but also 2, 3, and 4. In this case, you see here an eye for individual, and you see here these 4 LEDs, and these 4 LEDs indicates that these 4 tracks are now considered as target of this activity. You can go back and just press here, and then you see all again, and you see here all LEDs, or just one track, as we have seen before. But I would like now to have here these 4 tracks as target of this activity last. So when I press now function 1, all these playheads jumps to the last step. And this can of course also depend of the last step. For instance, if I have here defined the last step, let's say step number 12, and the last step of this would be step number 14, and I click here now function 1, then I see here, okay, this track jumps to their last step and this track jumps to their last step. It's not the same. But let's go here back to the default behavior, and then I see I just jump to the last, in this case step number 16, for all these 4 target tracks. Okay, so this is okay, but well, not very convenient, because if I always have to press function 1 to jump here to the last steps, it's not so helpful. But now we can use this routing we used before exactly for this behavior. When I have here now a step, for instance here and here, well, let's start with one step here, and I clock through this step. Whenever this step here now is active, the activity will be activated and this the playhead will jump here to the last. See? Let's simulate this very slowly. Standard behavior. And here now we have this routing. So whenever this step here is set and the player is here, then this will activate the function and the function will jump to the last. And again, well, in this case, it's already in sync, so nothing will happen. But if we reset it here and we take a look, then you will see now it will jump. Good. Okay, so let's make music. I have here some drums, and for instance here, I think this is a snare drum, and let's start this. Sounds normal, but now I can here define, in this case here, this playheads go to the last step and restart. Yeah. And so I can define, like I can generate my own patterns. It's like a pattern generator. It's not an Euclidean rhythm, it's also integrated in this firmware, but the Euclidean rhythm generator, but it's something different. And you see, when I change here the last step of the tracks individually, I have very, very funny rhythms. Okay, we have now seen 2 of the new activities, first and last. Let's take a look at all activities. We have here the activity mute, step, roll, effect. You also have Euclidean rhythm as own function, but you also can use this rhythm for one track. Then clock. This is a special activity where you can reuse the sockets here as external clock. So you can have up to 5 external clocks. And with this new possibility to not just have one target or all targets, all track access targets per activity, but to choose individually the tracks for this activity, I think this is really useful also for the clock. Then you can have an external clock for instance, track number 1, 2, and 3. We have first and last. Then the last and next pattern. In this case, you can't choose a track because in this case, the pattern will be defined by the sequence of this track. And then we have the new activities. I call these activities logic activities. You have top, bottom, up, down, and, or, XOR, and NOT, or the negate. And for these new logical activities, it's very important to define the targets. For instance, for this activity top, you define the target tracks. Let's say target track 1, 2, 3. And then only these first three tracks will be affected by this activity. And this activity is very convenient because you can here define a pattern. We have here, for instance, our hi-hat. And I think here is a cymbal. And here a cowbell. And now, when you activate this activity, function 1 is activity top for the track 1, 2, 3. Whenever I activate this activity, only one instrument will be played, the topmost instrument. So if you have here two steps for instrument 1 and 3, for instance, for track 1 and 3, then only the topmost, in this case, instrument 1 will be played. If I have here instrument 2 and 3 active, only instrument 2 will be played, the topmost. Whenever I press function 1, this activity will be active, and I can use this for a fill effect or to thin out a rhythm, or we will see it later also to generate very intensive rhythms. Another of these new logical activities is bottom. It's the same, but in this case, when I activate the activity, the lowest instrument will be active. So in this case, when I have here always this instrument set, only this instrument can be active because it's always set and it's the lowest. But if I have this rhythm here, I hear only one instrument, the lowest one, the lowest defined by this tracks here, and only considering these tracks I have chosen here. We have here an activity called upshift. Whenever I activate now this function key, these three instruments will be moved one line up. And so you can also have different effects. It's not a rhythm, it's the same rhythm, but played with other instruments. And this gives you a nice effect, I think. Or downshift. That's maybe the same. Now it goes down line. You have the same rhythm, but with other instruments. And only the three tracks here will be considered. So if we would have here other tracks, for instance, bass drum or a snare drum or whatever, this will be not touched. Only this target tracks will be considered. Then we have here an and effect. But now it's a bit IT. Like, so whenever I press now this button here, only the instruments were played at the same time will be output. In this case, only step 14 will be output, because only here we have all instruments set at the same time. We have here this rhythm, and then you can thin out the rhythm playing this activity or pressing this activity. Other effect. An OR effect. In this case, all instruments will be output if only one of this instrument is set. So if I remove this step here, you will hear a difference. Most of the time, all instruments will be output because an instrument has a step set. Then we have here XOR. Well, now it's with XOR means output yes if one step is set. But if no step is set, no output. And if all steps are set, no output at all. So in this case, this case, this case, in this case, no output. And in the other cases where, let's say, one, two steps are set, then the output for all the set steps is done. Also an interesting effect, so you can use it for a fill, for instance. It's more or less the same rhythm, but different. And then last but not least, this not a nor effect, negation effect. So in this case, all set step will not be output, but all not set step will be output. So we now have seen all the activities and we can now bring all together. But before we do that, I would like to introduce one last new feature. And as you have seen before, whenever I activated this activity, I had to press this function button. And so I have here now the end effect. And to activate this end effect, I always had to press this button. And this is sometimes convenient, but sometimes you would like to have the behavior the other way around, so that the activity is always active, because maybe you have an activity you would like to hear always. And for this, I implemented here a new like a button. If you press this button here, the activity is always active. But well, this is not exactly true. It will be deactivated, it will be switched off if you press this function button. So the behavior is the other way around. Normally it's always off and you can switch it on. And with this new feature, it's always on and you can switch it off. This is especially interesting for these logical activities, because some of these logical activities you like to have always on. For instance, if you would like to combine some Euclidean rhythms to a new rhythm, two or three, you would like to use this button or only play the top instrument. So then you have sometimes this effect, this activity always on. And then you can choose here always on, and it's always on. Okay, then let's try now this routine. So we have now this musical pattern here, this track number 1, 2, 3. And let's now use track number 7, track number 8 for this routine. So I change for track number 8 the gate mode to root, and I route it to the function 1. And I will use track number 7 and go here also to routing, and will root to the stop function. So when I press now here these four steps, when I activate these four steps, they are not output, These are now routing steps. So these four steps will now control the function one, and function one is, I think, the AND effect. And I press here now this button, in this case, the stop routing. So when I start now this pattern here, we have here a normal behavior, then we have a behavior with activated AND, and then at the end it's this stop and the sequence stops. Let's try it again. Reset, start. Well, I think this is not very a funny example, but we can change it now a bit. We can, for instance, define another clock divider for track number 7, track number 8. So let's do that. We got the clock divider and define here a different clock divider. Yeah. If we start now the sequence, we hear four times the same pattern. Then we hear four times the pattern with this AND effect activated. And then the sequence stops. So let's change this a bit. We would like to hear only two times this activity activated. And let's change the activity, not this AND effect, but let's say, this XOR effect, for instance, like for a fill effect. And now let's start it again. We will hear the pattern four times, then two times with this XOR effect, and then the sequence will stop. Okay, I hope you like this new release with these 10 new activities and also the performance modes. I will be very happy to hear about your feedback. Thank you very much.